Good afternoon, everyone. สวัสดีครับ. My name is Chanarong Pankhong. I have worked in Khaokhiao Peninsula, Thailand. I assisted Dr. Ratchaphan Pattanarangsan and Ms. Urarika Gongphom in hormonal monitoring the back neck stock. So I would like to present for you about assessment of breathing difficulty in CAP3 back neck stock. If you all in chat, Asia discuss. Is discussed by hormonal study at Khaokhiao Peninsula, Thailand. Okay, this slide show you the outline in the present study. I will start at the introduction and background. Then I will tell you about important objective and framework. After that, I will show you about method and result, and finally to conclusion. Okay, let's. To the introduction, back neck stock has two subspecies. That is, if you all in short, Asiaticus. Asiaticus is originated in Southeast Asia through India and Sri Lanka. And another one, if you all in short, Asiaticus australis is found in northern Australia and New Guinea. In several countries, the back neck stock has experienced the most severe decline in number during the 30 years. Its evaluation at nutrition on the IUCN red list. Now they are ancient in the wild of Thailand. However, there is a small population in CAP3 breeding. It is important that a viable population is maintained in captivity. Before that, it is one main objective of the Zoological Park Organization of Thailand to conduct conservation. This will help to conservation and also biodiversity conservation. Breakneck stock are in our focus of this objective. However, breeding in captivity is related. There are many factors that involving this unsuccessful breeding in captivity, such as stress and infertility. Stress and infertility can be a negative impact on physiological or behavioral response, and including the potential of reproductive of the animals. About the wildlife, the diagnosis and monitoring of hormonal are two of the most important reproductive evaluation, primary to the analysis of increased hormone metabolites. Okay, this slide show you about the objective in this research. To quantify level of stress hormone in breakneck stock from peahog extraction method, and to determine individual reproductive physiological status of each animal in different reproductive case, reproductive state in captive males and females. About frameworks, non-invasive method using in quantification of steroid hormone in PC is one suitable way for captive wild animals, and this method can avoid traumatizing or suppressing each animal from capture, and can be explained in the principle of hormonal metabolism. This slide shows you about the undetectable steroid in PC called peahog steroid. This non-invasive method is now widely used to investigate hormone behavioral relationship, as well as question in the fields of reproduction and animal welfare. Okay, about the material in this study, animal in this study includes the 4 male and 3 female backneck stock, if you are in short, Asiaticus, at stock captive breeding zone area in Khaokhiao Peninsula, Thailand. About the behavior of the birds was collected by using focal scan sampling techniques in daytime at 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. between October 2007 to September 2009. And we would determine spread and reproductive sex that using and receive hormone monitoring by collecting fecal sample at 3 times per week for 1 year. After patient sample were preservation with freezing or drying immediately, and then fecal extraction process is done by boiling method. This slide shows you the picture about the fecal hormone extraction. Okay, about the hormonal assay is performed by competitive ELISA or enzyme linked immunosorbent assay. According to Brown and other Smithsonian endocrine laboratory, the hormonal EA rely on a monoclonal and polyclonal antibody is provided by Friedel Corporation. This slide shows you about the immunoassay choice. The most common assays are based on competition between label and unlabeled antigen binding to antibody. This slide shows you about the hormonal assay at Tokyo also. Okay, about the data analysis, about the statistical analysis, was calculated using one-way ANOVA and F-test. Okay, about the results, fecal hormone assay has been used in several species. However, hormonal pattern in breeding stock can be reported eventually in Thailand. Okay, about the result of behavior. This slide shows you about two pie chart show the average of all behavior in daytime between breeding group and non-breeding group. The overall of their behavior was not different except that the breeding pairs group show social and breeding behavior more often than non-breeding group, and aggressive behavior of the bird in the small case was higher than the bird in the big case. Okay, next about the endocrine pattern. We are separate group of animal into various group for comparison as follow this slide. In females, we detected progesterone, estradiol, and cortisol. For male breeding stock, we detected testosterone and cortisol level. In three females from study population, one single female has successful to breed and give birth during a 2 year period, another not successful breeding. And there was no age difference between pair and non-pair females in this study population. About the breeding season in breakneck sock and Kokyomitsu, is to start at October to November, or delay on December to January. Okay, next, this slide shows you about fecal progesterone concentration between breeding and non-breeding females. Draw average 1 year out. The blue lines are progesterone level in breeding females, and yellow line are progesterone of non-breeding females. In breeding season, the progesterone concentration between breeding and non-breeding females were significant difference. Which pair female has progesterone higher than two non-pair females, but not different in another period. Okay, this slide shows you about the estradiol concentration between breeding and non-breeding females. Fecal estradiol concentration in breakneck sock female were fluctuated markedly up and down and were not useful for characterizing follicular activity. Although companies with estradiol level in female group, there was non-significant difference. However, estradiol level in pair female to be seen higher than non-healthy males. Okay, about the go to male back next spot. In contrast to females, there was different in average age of male group, which pair males was greater than 3 non-pair males. Okay, the picture show you about fecal testosterone concentration in breeding males. And this in one this one in non-breeding male group. Okay, there was no evidence of seasonality in testicular activity. Overall, mean focal testosterone concentration were higher in the pair male than in non-pair males. This picture shows you about the cortisol profile in breeding females. And this one in non-breeding females. Okay, for fecal, when compared the overall cortisol concentration of all females were significantly different between pair males and non-pair males. With pair male, surprising, pair males has cortisol level lower than to non-pair male. Female has cortisol lower than to non-pair females. And the study also found that the cortisol level was higher in the summer. Okay, about the this picture show you about stress hormone in breeding bagnet stock males. The study found that the cortisol level was higher in breeding season. Okay, and this picture shows stress hormone in breeding males. The cortisol level was highest in the summer. Okay, yeah, about the conclusion, the study demonstrated that the cortisol level was significantly different between breeding and non-breeding group, and the male breeding has the highest cortisol level in breeding season, while the female breeding has lowest. And the high temperature in summer season is one factor that can affect the cortisol level increasing in study population. There was no evidence of seasonality in testicular activity. However, fecal testosterone concentration were higher in the pair male than in non-pair males. About the fecal estradiol concentration in pregnant stock females were fluctuated markedly and were not useful for the characterizing follicular activity. And the progesterone concentration between breeding and non-breeding females were significant different in breeding season, but non-significant different in out-of-breeding season. Okay, our study breeding females show at least some evidence of ovarian activity which observed only in the breeding season. And they were overall of their behavior in daytime were not different between breeding and non-breeding group, except their social and behavior. And finally, the two factors that can stimulate the cortisol level of captive animal were temperature and pairing. This slide show you about the reference in this research. Okay, I'm sorry if you have another question. I can answer question after break because of the short of time and my English is not well. I'm sorry about this. Thank you for your attention. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Kun Chen Rong.